Welcome to Getting Started with a Light Motion, Part 2, How to Animate Your First Project. In this tutorial builds upon the project we made in Part 1, so be sure to watch that first. There's a link in the video description. Let's get started. The layers we made in Part 1 are only 2 seconds long, but we want to make a 4-second animation, so we need to make these layers longer. Tap the background layer on the timeline to open the Layer Options panel. Press the arrow at the end of the layer and drag it to the right until the duration reads 4 seconds. Now close the Layer Options panel. You can see that the background layer is longer than the spotlight layer. We want to extend the spotlight layer to 4 seconds as well. We could use the same technique, but instead, I'll show you a shortcut. Tap the spotlight layer. Now scroll all the way to the end of the project. Then tap this button to extend the end of the layer to the current time. When you're done, be sure to scroll back to the beginning of the timeline. Now it's time to animate the spotlight. Tap Move and Transform. The icons on the right side allow you to switch between adjusting the position, angle, size, and skew of the layer. The central area is called the control pad. You use this area to transform the layer. Finally, on the left side of the control pad, you will find the most important feature in a light motion, the keyframe button. This button allows you to mark certain points in time as keyframes. Any property of a layer, from its size or position to its color or opacity, can be adjusted separately at each keyframe, and a light motion will automatically animate between these keyframes, so you don't have to. Let's set up the starting position for the layer. Tap the keyframe button to add a keyframe. Notice that a diamond shape appears on the timeline to indicate that there is a keyframe here. Drag on the control pad to place the layer at the top right corner of the screen. Now scroll the timeline to the 0:20 position. Since our project is 30 frames per second, 20 frames is 2/3 of a second. Now drag on the control pad to place the layer at the center left of the screen. Notice that the second keyframe was added automatically. As long as you have at least one keyframe for a property, additional keyframes are added automatically when you adjust the property. Now add the remaining keyframes. Now scroll to the beginning and tap play to preview the project. That looks good, but we can make the motion a little more natural. Tap the Easing Curve button. Easing curves allow us to make movement that accelerates and decelerates, rather than moving at a constant speed. You can find out more on the Alight Creative website. There's a link in the description. For now, we'll just use a preset. There is a separate easing curve between each pair of keyframes, so be sure to scroll between each pair of keyframes and then tap the Ease In, Ease Out button. Let's try playing the project again. Much more natural. Now that we know how to set the position keyframes, we can use the same process to set the size keyframes. Tap the Scale icon to adjust the layer size. We don't have any keyframes for size yet, so don't forget to add the first keyframe manually by tapping the keyframe button. Let's have the spotlight expand to fill the screen. And don't forget to set easing for more fluid motion. One final touch. When you film an object moving in real life, it has motion blur. We can add motion blur in a light motion too, for a more realistic feeling. Return to the Layer Editing panel. Tap Effects, then Add Effect. Swipe left and choose Motion Blur. Once you're happy with the result, tap the Share button to share your video. Thank you for watching this tutorial. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more tutorials like this one.